Hello, astronaut Randy Bresnik. Well, we call it the International Space Station because it is international. And one of my crewmates that I'll be launching on the Soyuz in July with is astronaut Paolo Nespoli from Italy. Well, it turns out that many of the modules of the space station were actually built in Italy. So it's a direct correlation to the international cooperation we have between the crew members as well as the modules and the pieces that are built. Built in all these countries all over the world, it's the most amazing engineering marvel that we have in human history because it was built, engineered, and sent up to space and assembled for the first time in the, you know, inhospitable environment of space where it's plus 250 in the sun and minus 250 in the shade. Well, Paolo and I will be up there and we'll be right next to each other in the capsule, we'll be right next to each other in our crew quarters and working side by side for the entire length of our 6-month mission. Paolo's a wonderful guy and holds the distinction of being the first ever human to launch to space when he's 60 years old. We've had a couple astronauts turn 60 while they're up there. He's the first one to actually be 60 before he goes up.
Thank you so much for coming and talking to us today at STEM in 30.
Thank you for inviting me here. It's a pleasure.
No problem. We've got some questions for you. I know that you spent a lot of time on the International Space Station. What was your most challenging work you had to do on the International Space Station?
Well, I think one of the first challenges that you get when you go in space and you stay for a long duration is that you essentially have to become an extraterrestrial person. So when the people ask me, do you believe in extraterrestrials? Yes, I was one of them. So you have to learn to live in an environment where there is no gravity, meaning that the actual things that we do all the time do not work up there. And at the beginning, you really try hard to behave the same way you behave here on Earth, and it doesn't work. You cannot do things, things are not efficient, it's very crazy, and things like that. And then, after a while, when you understand this is a new situation, you need to explore, You need to try things, you need to become Superman, fly from one place to the other and, you know, do exceptional things that you cannot do here, then that's when you actually really start working. And it's a very good challenge.
Now, you flew both on the shuttle and on the Soyuz.
Yes.
Can you explain the difference between the two spacecraft?
The launch itself, between the two vehicles, it was pretty much the same, more or less. The shuttle is a little bit rougher at the beginning, but then it smooths out, and Soyuz starts very smooth, and then it gets rough at the end. But the re-entry is totally, completely different. You know, the shuttle re-enters almost like a spacecraft, almost, more or less. The Soyuz, instead, re-enters with a parachute, and the way it breaks in the atmosphere and everything that happens inside in this half an hour of horror, it's pretty much fairly rough, I would say. And you know, you are inside there, you trained from a technical point of view many, many times on Earth, but when things happen in there, you are completely, constantly surprised, and you actually kind of, whoa, what was that? Am I alive? Are we alive? And it keeps going like this. I usually summarize it, say that it's a sequence of catastrophic events that happen in rapid succession until you eventually go to the last part, which is the soft landing, which is equivalent to a car crash between a truck and a car. And, you know, you are in a car, not in the truck. And then you are on Earth, like, whoa, that was pretty good entry.
What was your favorite job when you were on the International Space Station? What was your favorite thing to do?
Well, you know, we work pretty hard when we are up there because, you know, we are one of the resources of the space station, and on the ground, the planning team tries to make the most out of this laboratory and the resources. So you're pretty busy, let's say, from 7:30 in the morning until 8:30 in the evening running experiments. You can be either a guinea pig or the hands of the scientist, or you can be going around fixing broken stuff, unloading a cargo, or moving the robotic arm, or even go out on a spacewalk if you are lucky. So all of us, and I did the same, like to go to the cupola and look at the Earth when it passes by at 8 kilometers per second, 5 miles a second. You can actually see in an hour and a half the whole world passing under your feet, and that's an amazing view.
Well, thank you so much for answering our questions today.
You're welcome.